Gospel Hour, making known to this nation the gospel of Jesus Christ. Stay tuned for today's message that was preached and recorded by the founder of the Gospel Hour, evangelist Dr. Oliver B. Green.
And now, here with our message, Oliver B. Green.
Now, we're studying in the Gospel of John, chapter 9. And we're using as the theme the master soul winner in action. Now, if we're going to win souls, there's only one way to win them. There's only one way to be saved. There are many religions. There is only one salvation. And I'm trying, by the grace of God and the Word of God, to drive home to your heart the fact that there is only one salvation, one redemption, and one religion that will stand the test of the judgment bar of God. That's the religion of the Lord Jesus Christ and the salvation that comes through the Bible way, not man's way, but the Bible way. Now, yesterday on the program, and today I suppose we'll finish with the young man, yesterday we saw a boy that was born blind. The blind boy was just standing or sitting by the road, and Jesus saw him. And he went to him, and he anointed his eyes with clay, and he told him to go to the pool of Siloam and wash, and he went, and he came away seeing. Now, when he came back, verse 8 says, this is John 9 and verse 8, the neighbors, therefore, and they which before had seen him, that he was blind, said, is not this he that sat and begged? Now, look at that, see. Some said, this is he. Others said, he is like him, but he said, I am he. I'm the fella. Now, he confessed it. Verse 10. Therefore said they unto him, how were thine eyes open? Now, there it is. How did you get your eyes open? Now, look. He answered, and he said, a man. Now, you see, that is called Jesus, made clay, a man. And he anointed mine eyes, and said unto me, go to the pool of Siloam and wash. He didn't say go and wash. He said go to a specific place. And he went. Now look what he says. Go to the pool and wash. And I went and washed, and I received my sight. Then said they unto him, where is he? And he said, I know not. They brought to the Pharisees him that aforetime was blind, and it was the Sabbath day, and Jesus made the clay and opened his eyes. Then the Pharisees said, he is not of God. He can't. If he was, he wouldn't work on the Sabbath. So I'm just telling the story now, and then let's skip over. Now look, in verse 24, then again called they the man that was blind and said unto him, now this is the Pharisees, give God the praise. Now notice, they believed in Jehovah. They said, give God the praise. We know that this man is a sinner. Now they're talking about Jesus. They said, give Almighty God the praise for opening your eyes. They said, we know that this man Jesus is a sinner. Now look at verse 25. He, the blind boy, he answered and said, whether he, Jesus, be a sinner or not, I know not. One thing I know, that whereas I was blind, now I see. Then said they to him again, what did he to thee? How open he thine eyes? How do it? He answered them, I told you already, and ye, if ye hear not, wherefore would you hear it again? Will ye also be his disciples? Now then, he said, I told you, fellas, and you didn't believe me. And there's no need to tell you again. I told you one time, and you wouldn't believe me. Now there's no need to tell you again. And so there it is. Now then, I want you to follow me closely, and in the remaining moments we have on the radio, I want to point out the conversion of this boy. Now he said, I got my sight by obeying. There was a man, they called him Jesus. He said, go to the pool of Siloam, I went. He said, wash, I washed, and I came away seeing. Now then, notice in verse 29, we know that God spake unto Moses, as for this fellow, we know not from whence he is. The man answered and said unto them, Why herein is a marvelous thing, that ye know not from whence he is, and yet he hath opened mine eyes. Now we know that God heareth not sinners, but if any man be a worshipper of God, and doeth his will, him he heareth. Now note, since the world began, was it not heard that any man open the eyes of one that was born blind? If this man were not of God, he could do nothing. They answered and said unto him, thou wast altogether born in sins. Now you see, they're judging the boy. Jesus said he wasn't born in sin. That is, it wasn't sin that stopped up his eyes. Jesus said that plainly. The disciples said, who sinned, the boy or his parents? Jesus said, neither one. But now this gang, they judge him, don't you see? They're judging. They said, you were altogether born in sin. And dost thou teach us? And they cast him out. They threw him out. This boy was testifying to the power of God, to the glory of God, and they threw him out. And I'm going to tell you, he's not the last one that has been thrown out for praising God, and he won't be the last, and there'll be some others. There's some of you folks listening to me right now. One of these days, you're going to be put out if you keep on praising God and living for God and giving God the praise. In other words, if you give no man, no program, no church praise today, if you praise God only, and if you worship God only, and honor God only, I'll guarantee you they'll put you out, they'll push you out, and they'll sever relations with you. I'll guarantee you, organized religion and organized dictatorship in the religious world will have nothing to do with you if you praise God only and give God praise only and you don't worship man and praise man and program and church steeples and finery. Now you mark it down. So they put him out. They cast him out. Now look at verse 35. Jesus heard that they had cast him out. And when he found him, notice now, he found him again. He found him the first time, now he's found him again. The boy wasn't looking for Jesus. Jesus was looking for the boy. Sinners are not seeking God today, but God is seeking sinners. Now look at this. When Jesus had found him, he, Jesus, said unto him the blind boy, he's seeing now, dost thou believe on the Son of God? Do you believe on the Son of God? Now look at this. He answered and said, who is he, Lord? Who is he, Lord? 1 Corinthians 12:3 declares that no man can confess that Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Ghost. All right. Jesus said, do you believe on the Son of God? Do you believe on the Son of God? He answered and said, who is he, Lord, that I might believe on him? Jesus said unto him, thou hast both seen him, and it is he that talketh with thee. And he said, the blind boy, and he said, Lord, I believe. And he worshipped him. Jesus said, for judgment I am come into this world, that they which see not might see, and that they which see might be made blind. And some of the Pharisees which were with him heard these words and said unto him, are we blind also? Jesus said unto them, if ye were blind, ye should have no sin. But now ye say, we see, therefore your sin remaineth. Now, beloved, there is a gigantic gospel truth that we need to see today. Some people listen to my voice right now. You say, Oliver Green, I don't need to go to an old-fashioned mourner's bench. I don't need to repent. I don't need to be born again. I don't need to call on God. I don't need to confess my sins. I don't need to shed tears over my sins. I've always been good and clean and upright and honest, and I've always been in the church. I grew up in the church. I was reared in the church, and I don't need to repent. You're blind. In other words, you claim to see. You claim that you're all right. But you're blinded by the God of this age. Your mind is blinded. And you're groping around in spiritual darkness. And one of these days you're going to open your eyes in hell. Now here's what saved the boy. Jesus came up to the boy and he said, do you believe in the Son of God? He said, who is he that I might believe in him? The Lord said, you've seen him, and it is he with whom you're talking. This is he. And the boy said, Lord, I believe. And he worshiped him. Worship always follows conversion. Worship always follows true salvation. You church members out there, God bless you, that can go to Sunday school on Sunday morning, then go home. You don't even stay for preaching. You don't go back on Sunday night. You don't go back on Wednesday night. When you have a revival, you try to make it out one night. Oh, yes, I'm going to try to get out one night. I'll try to be there one night. Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, I'm going to tell you one thing. You may be a member of a church, and you may be a church member, and you may have your name on the church roll, but you're not a worshiper of God. You're worshiping things. You're worshiping the fancies of your own desires, and you're not worshiping God. Now, the blind boy says, if I knew who the Son of God is, I will believe on him. Jesus said, I that speak to thee am he. And he said, I believe, Lord. And the Lord saved him and sent him on his way, a new creation in Christ Jesus, by simply believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, he didn't say, come on down, let me baptize you. He didn't say, come down to the temple and put your name on the book. He didn't say, be sure and bring all the tithes into the storehouse. He didn't say, be sure now and try to live the best you know how and the best you can. But he said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. That's the gospel. We are saved by grace. Grace is God's unmerited favor to a hell-deserving sinner. Grace is applied by faith. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life. Now, the boy was saved by believing. Now, here's what I want to point out as we leave the radio today. The Pharisees said, are we blind also, in verse 40, are we blind also? Jesus said unto them, if ye were blind, ye should have no sin. But now ye say, we see. Therefore your sin remaineth. You see, they said to this boy up here, you were born in sin. And here you are trying to teach us. Born in sin. Verse 34. They answered and said unto him, thou wast altogether born in sins, and dost thou teach us? And they threw him out. They cast him out. Now, you see, they were mad with Jesus for opening a boy's eyes on the Sabbath day. Jesus had healed a poor boy that had been blind all of his life on the Sabbath day. And they wanted to throw Jesus out and condemn him and kill him. And they said, why, that fella couldn't be of God. Even though he opens a poor blinded man's eyes, he couldn't be of God. He did it on the Sabbath day. You see, they were sold out to rituals and programs and religions and forms and organization, and they could not see. They could not understand. They refused to believe that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, was Lord also of the Sabbath, Lord of all, and able to perform a miracle that had never been performed. It had never been heard of up until that time, that a man should open eyes of a boy born blind. They were blinded by the God of this age. And the blind boy saw and was saved because he believed and he obeyed. Now let me review just a moment. And then I want you to ask yourself the question, are you blind? There was a blind boy sitting or standing by the highway begging. He didn't scream out to Jesus, but Jesus sought out the blind boy. He went over where he was. He didn't put a coin in his plate. Jesus spat on the ground. He made clay. He put the clay on the boy's eyes. He said, go. Go to the pool of Siloam. Not just any old pool, but go to the pool of Siloam. Now, there might be fresher water and cooler water and purer water in the pool of Bethesda, but I said, go to the pool of Siloam. The boy heard, he obeyed, he went, he washed, he saw. All right? The Pharisees have just thrown him out. Now then, Jesus walks up to him and he says to him, do you believe on the Son of God? Why, he said, Jesus, or he said, Lord, who is the fellow? If I knew who he was, I'd believe on him. Jesus said, I that speak to thee, I'm the Son of God. And the Bible says the boy believed. He said, Lord, I believe. And he worshiped him. Now, it was the word of God that opened his eyes. It was the word of God that saved him. The boy heard the word. Faith came by hearing the word. faith in the Word opened his eyes, and faith in the Word saved his soul. Now listen, sinner, listen. If a poor boy born blind, if a poor boy sitting by the highway begging, born blind, if he could have enough faith in the Son of God to make a trip to the pool of Siloam and wash his eyes, my dear sinner friend, can't you believe the Word of God? The Bible says, come unto me, and I will in no wise cast you out. Come now, and let us reason together. Though your sins be scarlet, they shall be white as snow. The Bible says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will, positively, give you rest. The Spirit and the bride say, come. Let him that heareth say, come. Let him that is thirsty come. And whosoever will, let them drink of the water of life freely. Now the invitation is come. You say, Brother Green, what will I do when I come? There's only one thing you can do. Believe what Jesus has said. Jesus said, if you'll come unto me, I won't cast you out. Jesus said, if you'll come to me, though your sins are scarlet, I'll wash them white as snow. Jesus said, if you'll come to me, I will give you rest. Now, my friend, if you're thirsty for God, if you're thirsty for salvation, if you want to stay out of hell, and if you want to go to heaven, then come to Jesus right now. Bow your head, bow your heart before God, and simply say, oh Lord, be merciful to me, a sinner, and save me. And he will. Believe what the Lord Jesus has said. He said, if you'll confess your sins, I'll forgive them. If you'll call on me, I'll save you. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. Jesus said to the blind boy, do you believe on the Son of God? He said, who is he? Who is he that I might believe on him? You see? Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me. Now, do you believe the Son of God died for you? Do you believe God sent Jesus to die for your sins? Then God bless your heart. Bow your head and say, oh Lord, I believe. Save me. And he'll write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life. Father, save those dear souls that are calling on you right now. Lord, those dear ladies, men, boys, and girls, they're down on their knees, they're calling, save them. Thank you, Father, for what you're doing now. Save the soul that's nearest hell for Jesus' sake. Amen.